depression of failure is much better than depression of success. In depression of failure, at least you have hope that I may achieve tomorrow. I may achieve tomorrow. You can postpone your hope, and you can have hope, and you can live with that hope. But depression of success proves and makes you utterly understand the truth, which leads you to the straight truth. As long as you have a hope, it acts like a buffer for you. You don't feel the truth directly, but the hope, when the moment the hope is removed, the moment you start facing the reality, the moment you start experiencing the truth, without the buffer, truth hurts. It is too much. You are left utter. You are left in a deep depression. You have nothing else to achieve. You have nowhere to go. A deep hopelessness descends on you. The deep hopelessness. And from this point, three roads are available to you. This is the point from where you can take in this someone of these three roads. One is drugs, which majority of the people desire. When you reach the success of depression or depression of success, you are successful, but you have not achieved what you really wanted to feel. You achieved what you want to achieve, but you have not achieved what for you want to achieve. Then the depression leads you in a place from where three roads are taking. One is drugs. Not only drugs means, not only I mean only alcohol or marijuana, all these things. Even food addiction is an addiction. Any addiction is addiction. At least with drugs, you know that you are doing something wrong. With food addiction, obesity, you do not even know you are doing something wrong. Even the obesity is because of the success of the, it is because of the depression of success. The countries who achieved the depression of success, all the countries are obese. Because they achieved what they want to achieve in the lifestyle, but they have not achieved the life itself. The life is sold for the sake of purchasing the lifestyle. You sell your eyes to purchase paintings. You sell your tongue to purchase the food. You sell your legs to pay for dance class. Lifestyle is achieved, but not the root core of the life itself. In the rat race, that's a beautiful saying. The biggest problem in the rat race is, even if you win, you are a rat, that's all. Even if you win, you are a rat. So, continuously, to prove your ego, you run. And finally, you feel like a fool. I have seen the people who continuously run. See, when you start to achieve something, you run. The moment you finished it, you suddenly feel the desire has disappeared. And I have seen many people coming and telling me, when I wanted to get a car, I thought the moment I get my car, my life will be heaven, Swamiji. Nothing else is necessary. But now I feel nothing much has changed. Nothing is happening. The moment you achieve, you understand, the whole thing is just your own imagination, your own feeling, your own thing. And the moment you achieve the one more thing, you realize you have paid too much for your desire. There was no such a deep desire. But you wasted so much of your time and energy in fulfilling that one desire. So the moment you run behind the lifestyle, one more thing, as long as you are running behind the lifestyle, you are continuously, you will see, you will be under the pressure, under the stress, under the torture. You will be jumping from here to there or there to here continuously, this way, that way, this way, that way, this way, that way. No time to rest and enjoy. Rest and live. Ultimately, a deep discontentment. That's the ultimate result of life. A deep discontentment. That is the seventh plane, the seventh emotion. If you are based on the lifestyle, you know, deep discontentment is the result which will come to you. In the end, there's a beautiful story of a king called Yayadi in Mahabharata. This guy said to be a man of greed, had all sorts of pleasure and enjoyed it for 100 years. When the death came, he is not ready to die. He says, no, please give me just only 100 more years. Death said, no, you already lived 100 years. Yayadi said, please do something. Death said, all right, if any of your sons are ready to give their life, then I will extend your time. One son said, all right, I will give my life. He gave and he was extended 100 years more. Again, after that 100 years, the end of these 100 years, death came and this guy said, no, I do not know how these 100 years passed. Please don't come so quickly. Death said, what is this? All right, one more extension. After all, you are a big king. Again, the third time, death said, no, this time no extension is possible. But somehow he went and got the recommendation of some god, and the recommendation worked out, that death allowed, all right. So the same way, continued for 10 times, 100 years. And after the 10th time, Yama says a beautiful word to the Yayadi, that king. You are pouring ghee to put the fire off. You are pouring ghee to put the fire off. Can you ever achieve that? Can you ever quench your discontentment by putting more sensory pleasures, increasing your lifestyle? Suddenly Yayadi had a glimpse of realization. Satori, the first glimpse of realization, Yayadi gets and he realizes, yes, why I forgot to look back? Now I understand. How much of ghee you pour, fire can never be quenched by the ghee. So how much of life I may have, I can never feel satisfied. So lifestyle can never fulfill the life itself. And the quantity, number of years, can never make you feel fulfilled. Only the quality of life can make you fulfilled. Don't add years to your life. Add life to your years. If you are in the mission of adding years to your life, you will never end. You will end only in discontentment. If you are in the mission of adding life to your years, be more aware. When I say add life to your years, I say three things. Live in the present moment. Have more awareness. And be totally conscious. When I say awareness, I am speaking about the outer world. When I say consciousness, I am speaking about the inner changes. Live in the present moment and have deep awareness about what is happening around you. And have deep consciousness about what is happening inside. These three will give you the glimpse of what I say life, or energy, or experience, or samadhi. So, if your life is more based on the being and the consciousness, you will see you achieve a tremendous satisfaction and tremendous feeling of fulfillment happens to you.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate share and explore in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore. 562-109. Contact 0974-22-033-11. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.